First, let's start with what is development. Development is the process that creates growth, progress, positive change, or the addition of physical, economical, environmental, and social and demographic components. Development is very essential in every sector. And I'd like to go directly to my topic, infrastructural development. Infrastructural development is the construction and improvement of foundational service with the goal of sparking economic growth and improvement in quality of life. If the infrastructure of any country is developed, then the quality of life itself increases through. So it brings the positive change towards the people. That development can bring some positive change in the changes in their life. There are two main types of infrastructural development, which include social infrastructure, which are schools, affordable housing and hospitals, and second one is economical infrastructure, which includes road, communication, sewage, water, airports, and power. There are common common types of infrastructures are transportation, energy, water, green infrastructure, digital infrastructure, social infrastructure, government, and resilience. I'll be focusing on transportation. Development of Nepal, Nepal's infrastructure. It all started back in 1992 due to rock terrain. The first shift of freight transport was naturally to the roadway. Basically, the transportation of Nepal started by roadway. It was first established in 1992 because the roadways were not so good that anyone can ride a vehicle in there. It was all the dusty and very rocky surface, so the roadway was very effective back then. These are the pictures of roadway back then. This one is probably of 1994. That I wouldn't know what from which era was it. And the second shift came in 1928 in the form of a railway line in Janakpur. The picture over that side is the first Nepalese train of 19. It was built in 1927, and this is the Janakpur Jayanagar Railway, which was operated at that time. Roadway until 1950s, the Kathmandu or any road of Nepal was not connected to rest of the world. After 1950s, by help of Ranas, the roadway was established in Nepal, which was commonly used and which is being used right now also. It is very effective and very inexpensive. Everyone can afford it. So roadway has been the most prioritized infrastructure in Nepal. Operating infrastructural development. Since 1950, after the after the roadway was established, the government has been making efforts to provide not only in the transportation sector as well as education, communication, health service, and electricity and other infrastructural services. Problem faced by Nepal. Although Nepal is trying to develop as much as infrastructure, Nepal remains the poorest country in terms of infrastructure. One of the dominant challenges is to develop the basic infrastructure to accelerate the pace of development. If the infrastructures are developed well, then it helps in the pace of development of the whole country. Hydropower, information and communication technology, irrigation, health, education, etc., as well as electricity transmission line, as well as technological development and innovation has to be developed in order to accelerate the socio-economic development of the country. These factors, if these factors are able to be developed properly, then it helps in developing the whole sector of the country, and which helps. And no one could be lacking in any terms of health services, and everybody could get a better education services. Who is financing the infrastructure of Nepal is basically the bilateral and multilateral agencies. the support of bilateral and multilateral agencies have been helping Nepal Nepal in constructing the roadways, ropeways or any other infrastructure which is conducted by Nepal government itself. All the highways, hydropower plants and airports infrastructure are being conducted by the supervision of bilateral and multilateral agencies. Infrastructure including road transport, education, health and hydropower are seen as a vital towards poverty reduction. This helps in reducing the poverty very rapidly, and which is basically the best thing we can have in today's era. People have shown their main interest towards infrastructure development in their areas. People are realizing that infrastructure development can bring a vital change in the development of country as well as their living standards. Development partners and multilateral agencies' support towards infrastructure development is increasing over the last few decades, which have been instrumental to set record of Nepal to its present status. It has from back then Nepal has come a long way in any infrastructural. There was not so much educational services provided back then, but now we have many educational institutions which are helping us and others as well to know what is proper development is and how can we develop in order to develop the whole nation. These two pictures are the I think these are the worst unskilled and worst infrastructure I have seen. There is a zebra crossing in middle of nowhere, which is very useless and waste of time and money. And the other picture shows the how the road transport roadway of Nepal is in current situation, which is very pity. I mean, people's perception must change. They have to realize that investing in infrastructural sector can be beneficial for their upgrade in their financial status as well as it can help in developing the nation as well. Citizens' money should be invested in procuring and developing infrastructure and services by private as well as public sector, which has been conducted rapidly, but which has not been effective due to some various reasons like the government intervention, some public are not so supportive to the development sector because they have some problems. They do not want to see the change. Like I visited Mustang last year, and the people there did not allow them to build the proper road because all the people want to visit there, and if they let the construction work to be completed, then within 2 days the people would visit Mustang and return back very soon, and their income would decrease very rapidly, which is not good for their lifestyle. So they do not let the people to construct the proper road for their own sake, which is very bad. I think that should be changed. Thank you. This is my presentation.
Any suggestions from friends? So we will take Santosh's presentation and then take a lunch break and we'll come back. I haven't eaten anything since yesterday, guys. Nothing from yesterday. Because morning time I was busy here. Daytime I had to present a paper that was the deadline for my university. And in the evening I was so tired that I couldn't wait for even half an hour. And look at my body. How
since I
tired. So after Santosh is done, we will take a lunch break.
Sir, coco bag lunch, sir. This
one. I don't know. I have done once.
Yes.
Santosh is actually the last formal presenter.
Yes.
Santosh,
No, I'm not sure. 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 I'm not sure
जुन जसको प्रेजेन्टेसन बाँकी छ
इन्फर्मेसन छ है भोलि 11 बजे हामी हिँड्ने भन्ने कुरा छ
11 बजे
सबै आऊ अनि त्यस पछाडि त्यो चिट अब भोलि नै जो जो जाने त्यो स्योर गर त्यहाँ साइन गर्नुपर्छ अनि त्यही भएर भोलि नै भन्छ है त्यो पेपर पनि आफै सोधेर छ हौ त्यो साइन चाहिँ अब को को जाने फिक्स छैन अनि त्यही बेलुकासम्म को को जान्छ ग्रुपमा नाम चाहिँ आफ्नो नाम मेन्सन गरिदियो ल सबैजना जानेको
चाहिँ कम्पल्सरी हुन्छ
11 बजे
जान्छले जान्छ हुन्न नि जाँदिनले जाँदिन हुने सरी
गर्नुपर्छ बेलुकासम्म किनभने एक्स्ट्रा हायस्ट पनि मगाउने कुरा